Ladies and gentlemen, Investor Talk is back with the monthly Matterhorn interview. I welcome Egon von Greyerz there. Egon, we live in dark times. Nevertheless, we, as we said in the past, have to educate our followership and encourage them to take precautions. Good to see you. Today we talk about many topics.
Yeah, always good to see you. And there's so much to talk about, sadly, a lot of worrying things, but we will always find some little light at the end of the tunnel, I think, and talk about some positive things also.
Absolutely, Egon. And you know, a small light is much more strong than a big darkness. Okay,
yeah,
let's begin.
Yeah.
We talk today about the Fed policy, probably a wrong Fed policy, savings, central bank, digital currencies, and gold for survival. Let's begin with the Fed. I found here this interesting graphic, Egon. It goes back until October, so we are now in the current cycle already here. This is the fastest rate increase cycle probably ever. And this, while we have the highest debt ever, I think, and I will prove this later on, this is something done on design to crash or to pop the bubbles. What do you think?
Yes, that's what they're doing, Jan. And as you said, if you look at this cycle here, we're up at 4.4% roughly now. In my view, and I'm very clear about that, interest rates turned a couple of years ago from zero, as we see here, and they are in a long-term uptrend. It's not going to be a straight line. There will be corrections. As I have expressed before, my view is that interest rates are going to go to at least as high as in the 1970s and early 80s, i.e. up to 20%. The deficits will continue, we'll have high inflation. But short term, you're absolutely right. Short term, this interest rate policy, of course, is not helping because a lot of the problems in the system now, the high inflation, is due to supply problems rather than demand problems. And you're not going to kill the, you're not going to rectify the supply problems by higher interest rates. On the contrary, you will make it go the other way, i.e., you will have more supply problems this way. But that's the way the world is going. I mean, you know, the thing is, we can discuss policy if it's right or wrong, but I'm very clear that it will continue and interest rates will go up because that's what the cycle tells me and that's what the trend is. That it won't be a straight line, there will be corrections on the way, but the trend is up and strongly up. And I think that's what we have to focus on. Central banks will make mistakes all the way, like they've done on the way down. It's crazy policy on the way down, zero or even negative interest rates. And this is going to be crazy too. But this is the way the world will go, sadly. High inflation, high interest rates, massive problems in financial markets. That's what I expect.
I found here an interesting article from Keith Weiner, and he describes there the Fed policy to lower the inflation by destroying demand. But this will probably totally backfire. Egon Weiner writes here, when the Fed says it's going to reduce demand, that's Fed speak for you losing your job. When you are unemployed, you consume less and prices go down. Recent tech layoffs highlight this fact. According to a site Layoff, hundreds of formerly high-growth tech companies have laid off over 100,000 employees so far in 2023. The supply cannot come back at today's higher interest rates. Macy's and other businesses cannot borrow at a rate higher than the return they expect on their capital. The higher the rate, the higher the return they need. Return on capital in retail can only rise by the closure of numerous stores. Therefore, the Fed's attempt to lower prices will end up causing higher prices. What do you think about this? I think he's completely right.
No, of course he's right. But you know, we have to remember that you know, the effect is of course that. They're actually going to exacerbate, you know, the situation, make it worse by these higher interest rates, and it becomes a vicious circle. But you know, we have to remember that the Fed is always wrong. They're always wrong in the policies. They're always behind the curve. And they never forecast anything correctly. They never forecast a recession, or they never forecast inflation correctly. And interest rates are always far behind the curve. And, you know, the fact, as I said, that they lowered interest rates for almost 40 years is absolutely crazy, and to 0% or negative. That shows you that the central banks are always there. They haven't got a clue. Central banks should not exist. Supply and demand and the natural forces of supply and demand should decide the outcome of the cost of money, for example, interest rates, nothing else. That will regulate the market in an orderly way. What the Federal Reserve is doing and all central banks is manipulating markets in a disorderly way, which will create the collapse that we were going to see in the next 10 years or whatever, 5 to 10 years. That's inevitable.
And they harm the middle class. We discussed this in the past already, Egon. The savings rate is low, and even the total savings are coming down. I think this is something absolutely new. Let's see the Federal Reserve of St. Louis. First, we have here the savings rate. Corona, very high, now even below average. But here, even more interesting, Egon, the next one. Households and non-profit organizations total time and savings deposits. And this is sinking, and we have here the data only up to the third quarter. So that is something we saw here, a small minus, but here it comes down harshly. So I think the people are forced to get into their savings to pay for their daily bills. And this is also something that brings the money supply down and popping the bubbles, of course.
Yeah, well, as you showed in this graph, and I think especially the previous one, so what, you know, COVID was, all of the COVID situation was artificial manipulation also, and central banks around the world, including the Fed in the US, gave massive gifts to the people, you know, gave them a couple of thousand a month, and all of a sudden, and they didn't have to work, and they still got money, and therefore savings went up dramatically. And then when it stopped, then, of course, savings rate collapsed. And now people have not only used up the savings from the COVID period, but they've actually now digging into credit, you want. So, and that's going to continue. So we will, it's always a delayed effect, but this is why we're seeing certain industries already suffering. The demand is suffering. Amazon, as a good example, closing depots, etc., because people now haven't got any money. COVID just created an artificial situation. And now we're back to a reality, which is much worse than it would have been without the manipulation or intervention of government and the Federal Reserve.
Egon, the current grave of the Fed funds rate, I'd like to show this also, looks to me like an anomaly. Over a long period of time, the interest came down from the early 80s. This was the real estate bubble. Here we had an increase, and it was already at zero in a totally indebted system. We reached the bottom, and now, as we saw it before, this harsh increase to over 4, you said it already, I think this is not normal, and there is behind a different purpose to do that.
Yeah, no, but and here we see clearly, you know, working lifetime, I experienced from 1970, roughly 69, when the rates were, well, up to 10, they went down to 2.5%, 3%. And then they went up to, as I said, almost 20% here in 1980, end of 1980, 81. And I remember it well. And now we've seen this long trend that has bottomed in 21. And, you know, the 4.4% where we are now, or 4.3 shows here, that's just the beginning, in my view. We're going to get up to where we saw in the early 1980s. We're going to get up to that. And the Fed, as always, will lose control. They're not going to drive it up there. Inflation will drive it up there. Also, of course, as banks start having, you know, bad debt increasing dramatically for the banking system, which has lent money that it will never get back. They need to secure their balance sheet by charging people a lot more for the money, and they will do also. So it becomes a vicious circle again.
The question is, Egon, if you can survive higher rates, I doubt this, and therefore they are pushing the agenda for the central bank digital currencies. I have here a very current example from Ukraine. One should think they have now really other problems, but no, they even push this forward. Mikhailo Fedorov, the minister in charge of Ukraine's digital transformation, said in an interview that he plans to speed up the process of creating the country's electronic hryvnia. When the pilot phase was first proposed, it was set to begin in 2024, but the government has decided to move forward to launch it to this year.
Yeah, this is
one thing that we see, Egon, this push forward, because I think they see the financial system is doomed, and so they have push on the speed button.
Exactly, and this is a very good example, Ian, why central banks around the world gradually are going to introduce central bank digital currencies, because the present money they have has lost, as we know, in the last 50 years, they lost 97% to 99% in real terms against gold. But now it's the next phase when he's going to lose all the rest of its value, or most currencies are. And therefore, they need to replace this money with another fake money system, and which is going to be digital currencies. Of course, they're going to try to park the debt and forget about it. You can never, debt can never be forgotten, because if you write off the debt, all the assets that the debt have financed, which is all the stock markets, property markets and bond markets, will also collapse. And that's what we're going to see. But in order to get some control of the monetary system, because the old money is going to be worthless, totally worthless, they're going to introduce these digital currencies, which they can obviously just push a button and click more money easily. But not only that, they will also have total control of what we spend and where we should spend it, etc. This is a very, very dangerous and bad development for the freedom of the West. And anybody who can should move to countries where they don't have digital currencies. It would be primarily in the West again, not in the East, not in the South, because it's the West that is indebted and need to do this, not the rest of the world to the same extent.
We see this force is Egon, but luckily also an opposite force. And there we have to come to Switzerland. For our audience, they find an article in the box. There is even a big initiative to protect the usage of cash, and I'd like to show this. We can only encourage the Swiss followership of our program to support this, and I read it. The Swiss Confederation shall ensure that coins and banknotes are always available in sufficient quantity. The replacement of the Swiss franc by another currency must be submitted to a vote of the people and the cantons. So there are also opposite movements to protect the usage of cash.
Yeah, now Switzerland, you know, its cash use is of course less than it has been, but it's still, you know, most people carry cash in Switzerland, and the Swiss money is really called, the paper is also high quality paper. So it feels like real money, although it's still paper money, but it's better paper money than in any other country in the world. You know, if you take in the last 50 years, the dollar has lost about 70-80% against the Swiss franc. The pound has lost the same, et cetera, the euro slightly less, or the mark at the time. So the Swiss economy has been the best managed in the world, and the money here is still worth something, not as much as it was, of course, but it is, people actually appreciate carrying real money, although credit card use, of course, has increased as large in all other countries. You know, I have two passports and Swedish and Swiss, and in Sweden, you don't have any cash at all. It doesn't exist. You know, everybody pays by credit card, and nobody knows what cash looks like even. Many shops don't even accept cash, whilst in Switzerland it's quite common. I mean, if you have a 1,000 franc bill, you know, 1,000 francs is a lot of money. This is like $1,000 or more or less 1,000 euros. And you know, nobody blinks an eye if you go and pay in a shop or in a restaurant with 1,000 francs here. And of course, as you know, the rest of the world, they couldn't have big bills of money, because then that was criminal always. So therefore, they abolished the 500 euro note, etc., etc. And same in America, but in Switzerland, you can still have 1,000 francs. There's no people, as I said, that's fine. People accept it without any problem. So yeah, paper money, the Swiss paper money, which as I said is the best in the world, people still have respect for that. So that bodes well for Switzerland fighting against this digital currency trend more than any other country in the world.
Yes.
In the Western world, I would add.
Switzerland is really a light tower in this
Yeah.
relation, absolutely. I just saw in press release in Argentina, we have inflation coming up to 100%. Then in Lebanon, we saw riots. And the crazy thing is there, the money is not only becoming worthless in Lebanon, people even do not get this from the bank. So your money is becoming less worth by the day, and you not even are allowed to get it. So it's also an argument to have gold and silver in your own possession, and it's really time to do this now. We see what's happening in Russia, Ukraine, etc. It's overdue to take precautions, Egon.
Yes, you take, you mentioned Argentina. Remember, Argentina used to be one of the richest nations in the world 100 years ago. Bad political leaders and socialism drove them to one hyperinflation after the other and one bankruptcy after the other and help from the IMF, etc. Sadly, I mean, it's a wonderful country, totally mismanaged politically. And then you see what happens to the currency. Now, there are a few people in Argentina who want to see this, who understand this. So they have always protected themselves with gold or maybe with a stronger currency. They held Swiss francs or dollars, etc. But for the people, it's a disaster because the people can't do that. They don't understand that. So the people are losing out every time you have one of these periods of inflation. And we've seen, as you say, that Lebanon is another example of that. And that's another disaster. And we're going to see that. And of course, Venezuela, we know, is a total disaster. And then we're going to have this in the West also. We're going to have this high inflation first that is coming now, temporarily slowed down, but it's going to increase again. And then eventually you will get to the hyperinflationary stage. It's inevitable because the money that needs to be printed makes that automatically this higher inflation or hyperinflation. That's going to come. And for people who don't protect themselves, and as I always said, you've got to protect yourself at whatever level you can, even if it's only with fractions of an ounce or a gram every month, whatever it is, just save a little a bit of money every month in gold or silver. And that will be absolutely worth a fortune for you when the bad times hit and the high inflation hits.
Yes, and I think even the high inflation can happen very quickly. I found here a little graphic from our friend Ronny Stöferle. Here it
Okay,
is, Egon, and this is only year to date 2023, Norwegian, Sweden, even in US dollars. So gold gained in those paper currencies, and this is only the beginning, I guess.
yeah, no, absolutely. The people don't understand it. People don't understand that because governments suppress gold, and governments don't like to talk about gold price because it reveals their absolutely awful management of the economy. So sadly, very people even know what gold is and what it means. But we know that our listeners or our viewers here, Jan, they of course they understand gold and they will buy gold if they need to and they should now. But the most of the people in the world will not because. They don't understand what gold does, or they don't understand what governments are doing to their currencies. They think that they think that prices are going up and inflation is going up. It's not at all. It's the currencies that are going down. We know that, but that nobody understands that because governments will never tell you that. Buy today because tomorrow your currency will be worth 10% less or 20% less. That's what's going to happen every year now. The value of the money in their pocket is going to decline dramatically. And people are not going to be prepared for it. And that's what's so sad, yeah.
Good final statement, Egon. We are living in dark times. Let's continue to give important information to our audience as long as we can. I wish you a good time in Switzerland, at your island of Switzerland. And till next time, Egon. Bye bye.
Bye, Ian. Good to talk to you. Thanks very much.
Thank you. Bye bye.